morning. Ta-da! It is Wednesday. Wednesday means, on my zombie yoga channel, zombie yoga. Zombie yoga means very gentle yin yoga. We're gonna stretch and stretch and stretch and relax. So today, I thought we're gonna use the wall. So I hope you have a free wall at home, which you can use. And also because I thought, oh my God, I can't dance forever. I haven't been dancing for a long, long time. I thought I'm going to get my shoes out. Ta-da! So I'm gonna be doing zombie yoga in my high heels because otherwise I can't even wear them. You don't have to, but if you've got some heels, girls, now it's the time. Let's get down to the So I really need you to that's it. I'm happy. And if I'm happy, everyone's happy. So first of all, I just need you to lift the legs up. You can open the arms, you can stretch the arms over your head. I'm just going to open them for now. And we're going to stay here forever. Remember, in yin yoga, we breathe in and out through the nose. And we breathe into our belly. Now, first of all, I would like you to bend your left knee and open the knee to the side. So we're just going to stay here. I'm going to, if you want to, you can gently press the hand into your knee. You can even cross if you feel like you want to cross. And just make sure you feel good. Make sure the hip is feeling okay. You can even put a block under your knee just to make it safe. You can do whatever you want to do. And let's stay here. slowly, gently help your knee because you will feel it. Straighten the legs, and if you want to, you can bend the knees. You can even gently lift the hips up, but be very, very careful. Don't hurt yourself. And when you're ready, I need you to open the other knee. So this side may feel a little bit different. You can press, you can open, you can cross, but make sure you feel good. Breathe, smile, enjoy. slowly, help your knee up. Be very careful because you will feel it. And again, if you want to move a little, do whatever you need to do. Just make sure the low back is feeling good, your legs are feeling good, and you're relaxed. Now, I would like you to gently bend the left knee and just bring the knee closer to your chest. We'll stay here, or you can even straighten the leg. Okay, it's just a little stretch, but you will feel it. So please don't overstretch. So I'm going to keep knee bent. I'm going to even rest my heel on the wall and just feel the stretch. the leg, straighten the leg, maybe move your hip a little bit, maybe you will feel it. Ooh. How's everyone doing in heels at home? I hope guys are not wearing heels. If yes, I need pictures. Oh yes, everyone, please send me pictures. What heels are you wearing for today's class? Okay, let's stretch the other knee. So you know what to do. I'm going to leave the heel against the wall, against the mirror. And I'm breathing slowly and deeply. good. Next one is going to be a twist. You have two options. The easy option is to open the arms and walk your feet to the right side of your mat. If you want to stretch more, you can straighten the legs down. So you can have your knees bent, or you can straighten the legs down. A little comfy here. If it's okay for your neck, look to the right, to the left side. Make sure your bum is still touching the wall. No cheating. And let's smile. Now you have to be very careful. Look up first. And then maybe bend the knees. Maybe help yourself up with your arms to push those legs up. Wow. Ooh. I hope you felt it. I hope you're feeling good. And we're going to stretch. We're going to twist to the other side. So again, open the arms. You can bend the knees and walk your feet slowly to the left. You can straighten the legs and then just look towards the right side. Check your bum, make sure it's still touching. And keep smiling. Thank you. back to the center, push through the arms, gently bring the legs up. Well done. We'll do one more posture up here, and it's going to be a butterfly position. It's a little bit harder with the heels, but we can manage. You can press your knees, hands into your knees, or you can hold your ankles. Obviously, without the heels, a little bit easier. So just do what you need to do. You can even stretch your arms over your head. Thank you. gently bring the knees together. You can lift your hips if you want to. You can move your legs. And it's Shavasana time. This one really, really quick for me. So if you want to, you can stay up here against the wall if you're still enjoying having your legs up, or you can come down into Shavasana and rest on your mat. Do whatever feels the best for you. Listen to your body. Don't worry, I'm fine with anything you do. Just don't break yourself. Okay, ready to lie down? And keep smiling. as you exhale, feel your body again. Start to move your feet, move your hands, your arms, your legs. If you're still with your legs up against the wall, be very careful. Roll to one side. If you're down on the mat, just bend your knees. Move your knees from side to side. And then slowly roll to one side and push yourself up. And come in into a seated position. And just close your eyes for a little moment. Notice how good you feel. I feel really good with the shoes on. I should do this all the time with the heels. I hope you feel stretched. I hope you feel positive, re-energized, and ready to carry on your day. As you inhale, circle the arms up. Bring the palms together. And as you exhale, lower the hands just in front of your heart. Namaste.